Hello, it's GE Challenge M here. I made a least act click challenge on Twitter, which lasted 3 days and has now been concluded. To know more about the challenge, check the Twitter link in the description. In short, you're required to bring clay, declocked and vodka to manifest in an as least as possible number of X clicks. An X click is a click which causes an X to appear under your cursor. You're only allowed to start with items in the newbie starter kit. Some things are not allowed, such as using other players or getting items which were in a player's possession before the challenge run starts. In this video, I'll show how to complete the challenge in 7 X clicks and I'll give an explanation of the methods afterwards.
Thank you.
That's it! Challenge completed in only 7 act clicks. I hope you thought it was interesting. Now, I'll give an explanation of all used methods. Notice that I moved to a location near the teak tree before starting the challenge. This is an important setup for the second act click. When your path is calculated, it is stored using something I call checkpoint tiles. These are the corner tiles of a path and determine the path completely. When you move over your path, you actually move from checkpoint tile to checkpoint tile. The movement towards a checkpoint tile follows the simple movement mechanics used by NPCs. This can be seen if an obstacle appears on your path after your path has been determined. Diagonal movement towards a checkpoint tile is prioritized, and it is possible to get stuck. When you click somewhere to walk or run, the game tries to calculate a path which brings you as close to the click tile as possible. But if you click deep enough into an unreachable area, no path will be found. It causes you to start walking towards the next checkpoint tile of your previous path. That's the exact reason why I started by going to this specific tile. Afterwards, I kept teleporting till I got next to the clay rock. If this wasn't done, a new path would be calculated to a tile next to the clay rock when clicking on it. So, instead of moving towards the teak tree, no movement would be done at all when clicking deep in an unreachable area. There are 24 teleport spots, but only one of them is good. On average, you need to teleport for a minute to get to the correct spot. This is the only element of RNG in the run, and it's not bad at all. Once getting on the correct tile, all remaining necklaces are dropped and the equipment stat screen is shown to start the challenge. The first X-click is done to mine clay. And as explained before, the second X-click causes me to move towards the tile I stood on before the teleport. All useless items are dropped and the shortbow is equipped to gain inventory space. We really need all inventory spaces we can get. The shortbow is kept because it's used to make fires later in the run. There was no good reason to not take the tinderbox instead. I just prefer barbarian fire making. The third click makes the character run to the teak tree and start shopping it. Instead of just shopping one lock for the challenge, a full inventory is chopped. Teak trees have a 1 in 8 chance to disappear when a lock is received. There is only a 4% chance to chop a full inventory of 25 logs without the tree disappearing too early. You would need to click on the tree to start chopping again, wasting a precious X click. But if you open an interface right as you chop the tree down, your interaction with the tree is paused. When closing the interface after the tree has respawned, the interaction is continued. This interface trick caused you to never have tried interacting with a chopped down tree, meaning the woodcutting process never stopped. Instead of a 4% chance to get a full inventory of logs in a single click on the teak tree, it turned into 100% chance. When hopping or relogging, your next checkpoint tile is set to coordinates 0,0 as default. To get an idea where that is, if this is the world map, the coordinates 0,0 would lie over here. Clicking deep in an unreachable area makes you walk towards your next checkpoint tile, thus causing the southwest movement. Next X-click requires a lot of game knowledge to understand. Start laying fires on this exact tile. Continue laying fires to move towards the west for a total of 13 tiles. Due to the relog at the teak tree, and due to the way we'd move towards here, the area load line lies exactly one tile towards the west. This is very important. The loaded area can be seen with Hoonlight, which calls it the instance map. When you right click a tile, the coordinates of the tile relative to the instance map are stored. If you keep the right click interface open while crossing an area load line, the instance map is updated while the stored coordinates remain unchanged. This means that if you select the walk here option, a path would be calculated towards a tile which is located on the same position as where the original tile was on the instance map. These mechanics are used for the fifth X-click of the challenge run. You may wonder why I started fire making so early. Indeed, if starting fire making later, less fires would be needed to reach the loading line. However, no pots would be found and no movement would be done. That is because pots are calculated in a 128 by 128 area with your character in the middle. With the location I used in the challenge, the bridge was exactly 63 tiles to the north, just within the pathfinding calculation area. If I moved any extra tiles south before fire making, the pathfinding calculations wouldn't have been able to find the path to the other side of the river. You may think I had lots of options for the tile to right click. Naively thinking, there are even tiles which would result in getting closer to the bartender than the one I used. However, doing this causes you to stop moving before you reach the end of your path. The reason for this is because after a path is calculated, only up to the 25 first checkpoint tiles are stored. The path used in my challenge run is exactly 25 checkpoint tiles long. The highlighted tiles show where you could end up if right-clicking a different tile. It's obvious ending up next to the cactus is the only good option. There is only one tile you can choose to end up on that spot. Also, note that I did a fire-making trick to walk west and then walk back east. The reason why this trick is used is again the 25 checkpoint tiles cap. If I didn't move towards the east again, the path would require 2 extra checkpoint tiles at the start. This results in the last 2 checkpoint tiles not being stored and you'd move towards this tile instead. Okay, so that's the reason why the fire making trick was required. But how does it exactly work? First, I'll explain regular fire making and then I'll continue from that. When you attempt to light a fire, the game will check the tiles around you in this order: west, east, south, north. The first tile which has no movement blocking will be chosen and you'll walk towards it. The tick afterwards, if you're not on the tile with locks anymore, the fire will be lit. With the double fire making trick, I start lighting a second lock on the tick the first lock is supposed to be lit. This causes my character to try to walk back on the tile with locks. Usually, when doing the double fire making trick, your character will move off and back on the tile with locks in a single tick. This is not visible client-sided. But standing on the tile with locks causes a fire making code to continue, and it picks the next direction in the west-east-south-north list. This version of the double fire making trick is not used for the fifth X click, but is used later in the run. While doing the fire making walk, you stalled for one tick. There are a lot of things which can cause you to stop moving during a stall, such as toggling run energy, losing a prayer point, gaining a hit point from natural HP regeneration, having incoming damage, etc. At this spot, there's not only an area load line one tile towards the west, but also a new map chunk. Map chunks are 64 by 64 areas which often have a unique music track. Entering a new map chunk also causes your movement to be blocked while stalled, thus blocking the movement back on top of the logs for a tick. Because my character is not on top of the logs anymore, the fire will be lit. Moving back on the tile of the fire still happens, but because a fire making code has ended, there won't be an additional east movement afterwards. It was important to not move back on the tile with logs on the same tick as moving past the area load line, because otherwise the new area would not be loaded. That was a lot of information to explain a single X-click. At Polnivnich, we need to get one tile closer to the bartender to make him visible. This is done using a double fire making trick, but this time we don't want to move back on top of the fire. That was ensured by flicking the rapid heal prayer, resetting the HP regeneration timer to 1 minute. After this fire, simply trade the bartender, buy vodka, and then travel to Manifest on a magic carpet. To end the challenge run, we need to get 2 more tiles south. There are exactly enough logs left to do that. Hop whirls to reset both the desert heat timer and the HP regeneration timer. This must be done after waiting 10 seconds because apparently we fought with the magic carpet. First double fire make towards south, then regular fire make towards west, then double fire make again towards south, and finally double fire make towards east. This results in a completion of the challenge in 7 X-clicks. Thank you for watching, I hope you have learned something new about the game mechanics.